Though I walk through the valley of the shadow, and I stand face to face with the enemy, I will know that I am not forsaken. You surround me when the fire's at my feet. You're my defender. You fight for me. I will remember. You're all I need. You are my healer, my remedy against the power of the unknown. And I will not stand alone, 'cause you're my defender.
Just a few words to share with you this morning, as we're less than 2 months out from the presidential election for this year. And many people are saying, as well as I, that a lot is going to be riding on this election. How things go with this country is going to be determined, many people think, by who is going to be in the White House. And while it is important, especially for Christians, to vote and pursue a particular direction as far as their vote, for the particular man that they need to vote for, I will remind you that God is ultimately in control. He causes and allows things to take place on this earth for His glory. I will remind you of the story in the Old Testament of Joseph, chapter 50, verse 20, where after he's reunited with his brothers who had sold him into slavery out of hateful jealousy and envy, he reunites with them and they're rightfully afraid, wouldn't you be? At his understanding who they are and recognizing them. And he says, it's all right. He forgives them. It's a great story of a wonderful thing that the Lord Jesus did for us on the cross of Calvary. So many similarities there, as it is obviously an Old Testament picture of what Christ did for us. It's a story of forgiveness and a story of redemption. But I want to remind you, it's also a story of the sovereignty of God, because he makes a statement in that 50th chapter of Genesis, as I've mentioned, in verse 20, you meant it for evil, but God meant it for good, that he may save much people alive. So all the things that happened to Joseph of a negative nature, and there were many, God raised and elevated him in spite of, because of his, God's, perfect redemptive plan to do and accomplish a work that mankind could not understand. He was able, and he's actually the only one able, to bring good from evil. And I want to remind you and encourage you this morning that God is still in that kind of business. As he gets ready to wrap things up, and I have no doubt, how long is it going to be? I don't know. But I do know things are closer to the end than they ever have been. I know that's profound, but it is true and accurate, I believe. And God is going to, doesn't matter who's in the White House, I believe things are particularly set in motion. Some of the lawlessness and anarchy are, it's not going to matter who's in the White House. People are going to continue to spiral downward in sin. But God is ultimately going to bring about things in the end time for his glory and for the good of his people. He's going to rescue. He's going to save. He's still in the saving business, thank the Lord. And I want to just be an encouragement to you this morning. Remember the story of Joseph, as God is in control. Thank you.